Hello and welcome to the 11th video of my Left 4 Dead 2 mapping tutorial series. Today we'll be learning how to create those fancy hints you frequently see in maps to help guide the player through your map. Hints are necessary for any map, but they're especially necessary for any complicated task the survivors need to solve, like finding a hidden object or hitting buttons in a specific order. It's frustrating to get in a map and not know what to do, but we can alleviate that with good usage of hints. Let's go into the holdout panic event we created in the last video. When players first step foot into the arena, they may be confused as to where to go. The door is closed and every other pathway leads to a dead end. This is a great place to put a hint. Place down an env_instructor_hint entity and open its properties. Give it a name, like event hint. Now there are a ton of options here to alter how the hint will appear, but we're going to focus on a few. Let's start with the caption property. This is the text that'll show with the hint. A fitting caption here would be, "Start the generator to open the door," with three dots at the end. Then there's a caption color if you desire. Next are the icon parameters. These are the icons you can choose to accompany the hint's caption. There's the timeout property, which will automatically end the hint after a set time in seconds. Finally, there's show on first sight, which will automatically show the hint when the entity is first seen. We'll keep it to yes for now. Now the entity won't actually display a hint yet until we determine its positioning. You could either choose for it to follow an entity in game or show on the HUD. Because this is directing players to hit a button, we'll want it to follow a target entity. And because we've chosen that, there are more options in this env instructor hint relevant to us, like force caption, off-screen icon, show off-screen, and icon height offset. I'm going to set force caption to yes and icon height offset to 24. We need to create the target entity this hint will follow, so place down an info_target_instructor_hint entity and give it a name, like event hint target. Position it where you'd like the hint to appear in game. Next, in env instructor hint, set the target entity to the hint target. Finally, let's add an output to the funk button that starts this event to end the hint when the button is pressed. Add a new output on pressed, target the env instructor hint via this input end hint. Now let's check all this out in game. If you don't want hints to show on first sight, you can make them show with inputs. I'll make another hint with the purpose of showing on the HUD, telling the survivors the door has opened. I'll turn show on first sight to no. I'll make an output in the door's properties on open, target the new hint via the input show hint. Let's check it out in game one more time. That's all folks, it's a quick one for you today. In the next video, we'll be making simple elevators. Thank you for watching.